Hi, I'm Rob Dana, and today I'm gonna show you how to set the valves for a solid lifter cam. And it's very easy. I just demonstrated how to do a hydraulic cam adjustment. So now I'm gonna show you how to do a solid lifter. What you do, like we did in the previous video on hydraulics, is rotate the engine. If you got it on the engine stand, you can rotate it with a couple bolts in the crankshaft and rotate it with a long pry bar. And until you get the valves, one going down and the other is loose. Once you've got the number, you start on number one and work your way down. So I've got this set right now to adjust with a feeler gauge. And it's very important that you look on your cam card to see what the spec is. And it'll tell you like 30 thousandths on the intake and 30 thousandths on the exhaust valve. So you gotta make sure. Sometimes they're split. You might have 25, 28. So 25 on intake, 28 on the exhaust. For just, you know, to illustrate how I'm going to do this one, I'm just going to do 30-30, which is actually the 30-30 Duntoff cam specs on a small block Chevy 302. So now that I've got you got to have a set of feeler gauges and make sure it says 30 thousandths right here. Okay, now we're going to take our feeler gauge, we're going to stick it between the rocker arm and the valve and slide it in and out, and we're going to tighten the stud nut down until it gets nice and snug, and you always constantly move your feeler gauge in and out. Okay, on this particular motor right now I have hydraulic lifters in here, and it's going to push down because it's a hydraulic lifter, but if you're doing a solid lifter cam, it's not going to do this. So just make sure when you're doing the solid lifter cam, you know, you got the solid lifters in there with the solid lifter cam. Right now I'm just showing you how to do it. You stick your feeler gauge in there so it feels nice and snug going in, and this valve is set. Now we're going to rotate the crank, or if you got the vehicle or the engine in the vehicle, you can have somebody inside bump the starter until this valve goes down. Right now this valve's almost all the way down. So now we're gonna bump it. Either bump the starter or I'm gonna rotate the crankshaft. And that's a good thing, because now we're gonna adjust the exhaust valve. Okay, now we're gonna put the feeler gauge on this exhaust valve. I'm gonna have to back it off because it's too tight, because I had just had it set for the hydraulic lifter. So see how I can put the feeler gauge in nice and easy now. Now we're gonna tighten it up to where it snugs up. Turn it till it gets snug. It's going to feel fairly snug. You don't want it loosey-goosey. Okay. Feels pretty snug going in. And that's how you set it. Now that we've set this number one cylinder, you're going to just go right on down the line. Do one cylinder at a time, two valves, these two valves, those two valves, these two, and these two. And you're going to rotate the engine each time. Get one down and adjust the one that's up, that's loose. That's the one you adjust. So just remember to rotate the engine till the other one goes down. You adjust the one that's up. And that's how you set it. And you'll be perfect. That thing will purr like a kitten when you're got them all set to spec like that. Sometimes you got poly locks. This particular motor doesn't have a poly lock on it. I recommend putting poly locks on if you're doing a solid lifter cam. That way you don't lose your adjustment, and the nut, you know, loosen up on you, and it kind of locks it in place with an Allen screw down the middle of the nut. So that's a highly recommended with a solid lifter cam. But you don't have to run them. I mean, you can still run the regular stock nut, but I recommend putting a polylock on there. Now this is a polylock. This is what I recommend putting on your rocker arm stud when you do the adjustment. This particular polylock is for a big block. So the studs on a big block are bigger than a small block. So I can't, you know, show you how to do it here, but you just thread it down the same way. And you got an Allen set screw. So once you set it down to where you want it, you back it up about an eighth of a turn and then tighten this Allen right here. There's an Allen set screw. You rotate that in with an Allen wrench until it bottoms out. And then you take your wrench and then snug it back up to where you were with the feeler gauge, and then recheck it with the feeler gauge and make sure it's good and tight and snug when you put the feeler gauge in there. So that's a polylock.